that the tafakkur and the contemplation to keep the madad of the shaykh is that to always see with your spiritual eye that the shaykh is right there present with you. That to keep that connection, na tariqatana sohba wa khair fi jamia, is that Mawlana Shaykh Shah Naqshband's expression for the tariqah is that the blessing in the gathering and keeping the gathering and the coming together of the association, but more that these awliyaullah talk from malakut and the paradise reality. The paradise reality of what they're teaching us is that they keep the connection with the paradise reality. It's not only the 10, 20 people that are sitting in physical presence, but it's that they train to sit in the spiritual presence. As soon as the association start, they see the ruhaniyat of what Allah want them to see, and they keep their connection with that world of ruhaniyat. That world of ruhaniyat brings every hawla and quwwata from Allah, not from the physical world. The physical world is like a fake fruit. It may look nice but it's plastic and most likely wax. You bite into it and there's no benefit, but it looks nice. The real fruit that awliyaullah come into our life is that from those whom are connecting with paradise realities, that through their chaining and through all their disciplines that Allah put them through, their Ahlul Basir, their hearts are open. As soon as the associations are taking place, they are connected into the paradise reality, the world of light in which they see their shaykhs all in that association. They see the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad in that association, and by means of that association they bring a fayaz, they bring a madad and support, they bring quwwah, divinely power into the physical realm. Means they connect with the spiritual realm, they bring the energy into the physical realm, by means of that is the barakah, is the cleansing and is the blessing. And that's what Mawlana Shaykh Shah Naqshband wanted for us, is make the connection to the real association. Not the association of the physical world only, but the physical world is a means in which to connect with the spiritual realm, to connect with that reality. That realm is hawla wa la quwwata, means that Allah's support. Where's that? Allah's support in power and madad is on the spiritual realm. The spiritual ruhaniyat, the atomic reality, it controls the world of form, not the reverse. Everybody becomes so dunya oriented, they think that the physical realm controls the spiritual, but no, it's the reverse. It's the spiritual realm that controls your physical, it's your nucleus that controls the electrons, it's the inner power that controls the outer. If the outer is deficient, something wrong with your inner reality. If it's not strong enough, it's not able to defend your physicality. So it means then the madad, the contemplation, the whole tariqah is based on finding these Ahlul Basira, because they are like a power plant. Depending upon the association and what's needed, Allah begin to release the fires through that connection and through that heart. Our life is to ittaqullah wa kunu ma sadiqeen. It's all Holy Qur'an and all hadith, but can't sit here and try to prove everything for everybody online. Is I can teach an alim in two words, but a crazy person, I'm defeated. Imam Shafi said. Someone who's knowledgeable, you teach them two, three words, they say, it's haqq, what you're saying is truthful, but try to debate with a crazy person, you've already lost. So means these teachings are not for crazy people, not physically impaired, but I'm talking about when you really just trying to be square-headed and not understand the world of light. But the world of light, it dominates everything. The malakut kulli shay, Allah describing. That my malakut, my paradise powers, it is all encompassing. If you tap into that power, it changes everything in the physical realm. But people are trying to live a physical life, connect to physical beings and hoping something going to happen and change with their spiritual reality, which not going to work that way. So means then the whole tariqah is based on trying to make the spiritual connection. That with these shaykhs, with these guides, that they're Ahlul Basirah, the signs are evident upon them that you connect, keep their company. As you're keeping their company, keep your vision upon them, keep your gaze upon them, that in all your salah and everything that you're doing at the end of your salah, sit down and meditate and, Ya Rabbi, your words are, Kullu ma sadiqeen, and I heard and I obey, I want to keep their company. That I see them not only at the zikr but when I'm sitting at home, I want to be in their presence. That I know that you're watching me because your nazar has to be upon me. Allah gave these guides a responsibility. That anyone whom is introduced to their eyes grab that soul and is responsible for them. And then they teach that as a, if you want to receive their fires, now whether you're going to use this emanation for a power to dress you with, to bless you with or protect you with, depending upon what circumstance your life is going to come, you're going to need to tap into that energy. And your mama's not going to help you here, your baba's not going to help you here. Allah wants you to be with a living guide. Even He told Sayyidina Yusuf as-salam, your father Sayyidina Yaqub is a different reality. I want you to be trained under a different, I put you in a child. Right? You can't say, oh, my father is the one who's going to guide me. No, if Allah says, no, your father has a different reality. For this day and this time, Allah may want you under different guidance and tarbiyah. And the fires that coming from this shaykh is not something that, you know, your pious mother and pious grandfather could help you with. This is something that they went through training and they've been certified in that reality. When everything's good, you make your connection and you receive the fires, the emanation like a power plant. It's not worshipping. Allah's the only one to be worshipped. But it's Allah's obeying that, Kunu ma sadiqeen, keep the company of truthful servants. Not only physical, because Allah's not concerned about the physical world. Allah's interest is in the ruhaniyat, in the spiritual world. So keep with their souls, keep the company of their souls. See them in your spiritual eye and say that, I always want to be with you, dress me from your lights, keep your nazar upon me. And then they begin to test you, how strong is your connection? Means are you able to keep that link, keep that connection, keep that light to come? And then they begin to test you through difficulty. If difficulty comes towards you and you're not calling out for that support, you're not calling out for that help, then that becomes a difficult test. So many times people will be given a test in their dreams where they're going to try to defend themselves. And this way is based on humility, not based on arrogance. Pharaoh was arrogant, Allah's way is based on humility. As soon as you're tested with a difficulty, Allah, Prophet and all the ulul amr are watching. How are you responding in your difficulty? I will go and get it and resolve the issue myself. Wrong. Because you'll find that whatever you tried to do didn't work. They begin to attack you in the dream, or some whom have a more spiritual being, they actually feel attacks coming to them. Those whom are very spiritual, they will be fully attacked and actually enter towards the physicality and attack the physicality. And the training is that why you're not making the madad, why you're not making your connection, why you're not making and trying to connect with them. Your mom can't help you here. This is not a joke, this is not a game, this is not a dumb and just making a dua. That's what's on this earth right now, it is a tremendous energy needs to be coming through the heart. And these are trained servants for this reality. When you're under attack and under spiritual attack and under difficulty, you should have been learning on how to connect. Don't wait for difficulty to come. That when you're learning how to connect, that I want to be with you, send your fires upon me, dress me from your light, dress me from your light. You live in the world of peace like that. So that a day of difficulty when it comes, you feel that connection. That Ya Rijalullah, that keep your nazar upon me, difficulty coming, you feel a support coming. You see the ruhaniyat of the souls that are all around you to protect you. Because Allah is guarding the soul. Allah says, "Afarin, good job, you learned a way of humility." If Allah doesn't train the servant in that way, and the servant is in his tarbiyah raised to think he's self-sufficient, then he's going to say, "I don't need anyone, I don't need the prophets, I don't need the angels, I only deal with Allah." Oh, the aqeedah of that was shaitan. Shaitan said those words, "Bow down to Bani Adam? I will never do, no, I'm only with Allah." But Allah said, "Then get out of here, because your belief is arrogant." Allah wants humility. Means whatever power Allah give to you, appear to people to be weak and nothing. That I'm nothing, Ya Rabbi, I'm Abdul Faqir, I'm Ajiz, I'm nothing, Ya Rabbi. But if Allah want me to be something, that's up to Allah. So then we took a life of humility, "Ya Rabbi, I'm nothing, I'm nothing. Keep me in the company of those whom you favor. Whatever you dress them of lights, they dress to me, keep me to be in their association." And that's what Mawlana Shah Naqshband wanted for us, that our way is based on the gathering. Keep their gathering 24 hours a day as much as you can. Train to see that I'm with them, that I'm at work, I'm with them. When I'm praying, that dress me from your lights. I'm praying, I don't know where my prayer is going. I don't know what thought all of a sudden. As soon as I say, "Allahu Akbar," 10,000 thoughts of bad things coming into my heart. Ya Rabbi, I don't want to pray like that. I want to be with them, that they're the imams that keep me in your association, keep my soul in your association, so that when I make my "Allahu Akbar," that I'm praying with them. And they're praying in the presence of who? In the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad. They're all in Medina praying, and Prophet is eternally their imam, and Prophet is picking and taking all of them to Allah. Just like the Isra wal Miraj, when everybody had to go to Jerusalem, and Prophet led all the nations, and all the prophets had to pray behind Sayyidina Muhammad. So, I mean, this way is powerful, this way is very real. It's a matter of how much you want to put it into our lives. Train on a good day so that you're prepared for a difficult time and a difficult day, inshaAllah.
Welcome to Muhammadan Way YouTube channel, your premier destination for videos on Sufi spirituality, classical Islamic teachings, and realities of the soul. With a library of over 1,000 videos and new titles uploaded weekly, join us to discover true meaning and inner peace in our often troubled world. Click the link now to subscribe.